Hello everyone, this is part 1 of correlation and regression. In this session, we will learn what is correlation and what are different methods to find out correlation between the variables. Let us see what is correlation. Correlation is defined as correlation studies and measures the direction and intensity of relationship between the variables. In simple words, we can say that correlation indicates the relationship or association between the two variables. We have different types of correlation. One is called positive correlation, the second one is negative correlation, and third one is called zero correlation. Let us see what is a positive correlation. Say we have two variables V1 and V2. If increase in one variable results increase in another variable, or if decrease in one variable results decrease in another variable, then we can say that the two variables are positively correlated. For example, the more the temperature is, the more the power consumption will be, as we tend to switch on fans and air conditioners, right? So we can say that temperature and power consumption are positively correlated. Negative correlation, increase in one variable causes decrease in another variable, or decrease in one variable results in increase in another variable. Then it is called a negative correlation. For example, the more speed you drive the car, the less time it takes to reach the destination, right? So speed increase results in time decrement, right? If you go slowly, that is decrease in speed results in increase in time to reach the destination. So we can say that speed and time are negatively correlated, right? And in case of zero correlation, from the word we can understand that there is no correlation, there is no relationship or association between the variables. Then it is called zero correlation. From these examples, we can say that there is no correlation between temperature and speed of a car. So we can say that it is a zero correlation. So from these types of correlation, we can define direction of correlation. Now, let us look into different methods to find out magnitude of correlation between the two variables. First one is a scatter diagram, which is a graphical representation of correlation between the variables. Second one is curl Pearson's product movement correlation coefficient, which is useful to find out linear correlation. Third one is Spearman's rank correlation coefficient, which is useful to find out correlation between quality data. And fourth one is called coefficient of concurrent deviation, one of the simplest method. Here we are not concerned about magnitude of correlation, we can use this method. Let us discuss these methods in detail. Let us understand how we can find out correlation between the variables by using scatter diagram. In case of scatter diagram, x and y variables are represented by data point in xy plane. Say this is x and y coordinates, and each point represents pair of x comma y. Now, after locating all these points in the xy plane, if the plotted graph extends from lower left corner, this is called lower left corner, to upper right corner, then it is called a positive correlation. Say if the plotted points looks like this, then it is known as a positive correlation. If the plotted points is a straight line passing through the origin, then it is called a perfect positive correlation. If after plotting the points in xy coordinate axis, if the points looks like this, that is from upper left corner to lower right corner, right? This is called upper left corner to lower right corner, then it is known as negative correlation. And if the plotted graph is a perfect straight line, then it is called a perfect negative correlation. So from this graph we can understand whether it is a positive or negative correlation just by looking at the diagram. So we can say that scatter diagram is easy method to find out correlation between the variables. Let us look into two more types of correlation. Say we have, this is the x-axis and y-axis. If after plotting the graph, if the points are scattered in xy plane like this, then it is called zero correlation. Whereas in the xy coordinate, that is after plotting xy points, if it is like this, then we can say that it is a curvilinear correlation. So from these diagrams, we can say that by using scatter diagram, we are able to identify direction of correlation, whereas we cannot find out magnitude of correlation. So in order to find out magnitude of correlation, we will use other methods. In next session, we will discuss three different methods to find out magnitude of correlation between the variables. Please subscribe to our channel for latest updates. Thank you for listening and have a nice day.